Hello everyone, I am Phoenix Tremaine, and this is my review of Gabrielle Union's movie, Breaking In. If you haven't done so, please take a minute to subscribe. If you have subscribed, thank you very much. If you really like my videos, make sure you hit that bell so you're notified every time a video drops. I got comedy coming, talk shows coming, I got a lot of good things coming to you. But you're here for Gabrielle Union's Breaking In. And before I saw this movie, I looked at one review. I didn't watch the whole review. I watched like the first 2 minutes of it, of a reviewer on YouTube that usually is on the same page that I am, but he referred to this movie as a Lifetime movie and that, you know, essentially it wasn't a good movie. So I said, let me go in this movie with an open mind. I immediately turned his review off. I didn't want him to give me any details. I didn't want to be, you know, I didn't want any interference in how I perceived this movie. So I sat there with an open mind. This movie is produced by Will Packer. He's done Ride Along, Think Like a Man, Almost Christmas, Girls Trip, and he did No Good, Good Deed, which I liked a lot. So, I won't say a lot, but it was a good movie. I wasn't mad when it was over. My money was well spent. I had fun for an hour and a half. Lots of tension. Taraji did her thing. But now it's like, can Gabrielle Union do the same? No. No. The other reviewer was right. I mean, if this was a Lifetime movie, I would have turned it off. This movie is so boring. There is no suspense. And the trailer is so misleading. It's like, in the trailer, she's this bad chick, and she's always saying, oh, you don't know who I am, and stuff like that. So we like, yeah, what are you, ex-military, martial arts, what's going on? Gabrielle Union gets her tail handed to her. She gets smacked around so much in this movie. Smacked around, knocked around, beat up. You know, she's not really a fighter in this movie. She's more of a scrapper. Like, she just barely gets past the guys. Like, every time it's like they beat her up, and then, you know, she's like keeps going. And we were laughing after the movie because we're like, her hair, all that, her ponytail stayed intact. She barely had any bruises. My friend says she had one bruise. I didn't see any. You know, I'm like, you still look like, you know, after each scene you went in the hair, makeup came back, and was ready to do the next take. Is like, this movie, I just was like, the kids are boring, have no personality. I know how this type of movie is usually written. They don't do any of that stuff that would make it good. There was a few gasps in the theater, some couple of things that happened. But for the most part, you know, everyone leaving the theater was like, well, you know, it was a movie. You know, so it was, I'm just warning you now that this is not a movie to rush out for Mother's Day to take your mother to. This is more of, if it's on Netflix, I guess, why not watch it? You know, if you have a way to watch it, like, you know, if it's on HBO, Showtime, BET, whatever, go on and watch it. You know, if you choose not to keep on, then don't go. Don't, you can turn it off. You know, I was stuck in the theater, and the whole time I was waiting for her to be a bad MF, like the trailer promised me. And yeah, she got a couple of kicks in, but for the most part, I was so disappointed that she constantly got beat up. You know, tiptoeing around the house. You know, it was just a lot of the scenes, and then the money. You know, we, the money, like, the money. We see the movie, and you know what I'm talking about, like, so y'all just rich. Y'all ain't worrying about this $4 million. You know, you hear the police sirens coming, you know, and you still ain't trying to, you know, maybe throw the money back in the safe or something. You know, I'm just saying, like, I was like, what about the money at the end of the movie? What about the money? Like, do y'all get to keep it? Do you not care? Are you rich and we just didn't know it? You know, the bad guys in this movie are very, I should look up who wrote this, because what, I don't know I mean, these bad guys were horrible. They were very poorly written, and their motivations are all over the place. So I'm like, you got one that's a cold-blooded killer that wants to kill everybody. You got one who's the mastermind. You got one who's, like, scared. And, you know, he's definitely the snitch of the group. And you got one guy who's sort of like the code breaker for the safe, who you turns out probably didn't need anyway. So there was that's my problem with this film. One, there's no character development. Two, there's no real action sequences. All the action you see in the trailer, that's pretty much it. You know, and the fact that the trailer, the way it's edited and the way the commercial's edited, it looks like she's like some paramilitary, you know, just retired type chick that is going to be setting traps and whatnot. We've seen this movie before. We've seen it before. Yes, it's usually the opposite. Yes, you're usually trapped in the house trying to get out, but now she's out trapped outside the house trying to get in. But it's still the same dynamic. And it just wasn't, the movie wasn't smart enough to create situations that were suspenseful enough to make you go, ooh, what's going to happen next? You know, no, it's like, okay, so she was behind him and ran into the next room. Okay. She's holding on, dangling from the, you know, the steps, and, you know, will he be able to hear her or see her, you know? Okay. It's just not a very good, well-written movie. And I like Gabrielle Union. I had high hopes for this movie, but it sucked. I'm sorry to say it. This was not a good movie. The kids weren't smart. Like, the kids didn't really add anything much to the movie. There's this one scene where the daughter is got like a fragment and she's tied up and she's like trying to get out of the ropes that she's tied up with. And I'm like, you've been doing that for like 5 minutes or more. It's like she's doing it for so long. I'm like, yeah, she would have been got out of that. So, okay. But anyway, then the kids, they get the gun at one point, and there's a quick cut, and you never see what happens next. You don't know how the bad guys got the gun from the kids. And then there's that moment in the movie that made everybody in the theater go, ugh! Okay. I'm just going to spoil this one little moment for you. I just cut a watermelon. If you have a knife and you stab a bad guy with it, do you A, keep the knife in case the bad guy's not dead or that somebody else isn't dead, or you just want to hold on to the knife because you don't know what's going to happen next? Do you B, drop the knife, start crying, and hug your kids, and you drop the knife next to the bad guy, and you run over and hug your kids, and you're sitting there crying? What scenario do you think made everybody in the audience go, ugh? Her keeping the knife for protection, or her dropping the knife and cry with the kids? That's the kind of movie this is. That's the reason why this movie sucks. Nobody was thinking. And then there's this quick scene with Jason George. Now, the son in the movie is useless. He cries, he's just crying tears and whatnot, and scared the whole movie, except the little gun scene, which everybody's like in the audience is screaming what he's supposed to do. He don't do it. That's because it's the stupidity. Like, people in the movie, like, you know, in other types of movies like this with other people, they usually do stuff like drop the knife or don't shoot the gun or whatever. You know what I'm saying? So, when us black folk get in the movie, we're normally shouting what you're supposed to be doing in these situations. And the characters should know what to do in these situations, so we shouldn't have to be shouting it. You know what I'm saying? Because the whole theater was black. So, you know. And then Jason George character, he's only in briefly, because this is about the women. It's a Mother's Day movie. But I was like, really? Did this really just happen? Really, movie? So, I'm not going to let this movie, this review drag on any further. I only meant it to be like a 5-minute review. But just thinking about it just reminded me of how I wasted so much money to see this movie. I spent $31 to see this movie in tickets. And because it's in a bistro, we spent $70 or $80 in food and drinks. So to see Gabrielle Union's movie Breaking In, we spent between food, drinks, and movie tickets, we spent over $100. So yes, I'm not happy. But luckily, Deadpool 2 comes out next week, and hopefully that's going to be a good movie. No, Breaking In was just a huge disappointment. So thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this review, I've got more coming. But I'm just going to give you my honest take on it. And thank you for watching. And in the comment section, if you've seen it, let me know what you thought about Breaking In. Okay? And were you sitting in the theater pissed like the rest of us, like, why didn't you do this? Why don't you do that? Why did this just happen? Why this movie would be over if you just did this? You know what I'm saying? Stuff like that. You know what I mean? There was even a point where they could have point blank killed her and didn't. So, whatever. So, not a good movie. See it at your own risk. Thank you for watching.